Hey guys, I'm Rich Alvarez and welcome to the Rich Vlog. So you guys remember Khal Drogo, Jason Momoa from Game of Thrones? Well, now he's gonna be Aquaman in the upcoming DC Cinematic Universe, to of course compete with the Marvel Cinematic Universe. But do you notice something funny about this picture? So I would now like to introduce to you, whoop, the five rules of Rich Alvarez comic book adaptations. Rule number one, heroes should at least look very similar to their comic book counterparts. Every time they make a Superman movie, Clark Kent is usually dark-haired, glasses, and tall. So if you were to say have a pudgy Superman who was blonde with a big bushy beard, I think people might have a problem with that. So my first problem with this Aquaman is that his hair is black when it really should be blonde, as is tradition. Rule number two, a hero's costume should at least be the same colors as it was in the comic book. You'll notice in this picture that Aquaman's colors look very subdued, almost like silver-like. You can maybe see a little bit of yellow, maybe some green over here, but for the most part, it looks very silver. Now, I hope that is just a pre-production photo and that they'll color it later or something, but right now, I'm kind of missing my orange and green. Rule number three, my third rule is that any comic book adaptation should at least be very inspired by a specific story from the comic books. Iron Man 3, the Mandarin was an actor, he totally wasn't even the Mandarin, and everybody who loves comics was sad that day. I really trust Zack Snyder, probably more than most. I love 300, I love Watchmen. So I hope that he will do justice with Dawn of Justice and the Justice League. I do have some problems with this Aquaman right now, but I will reserve final judgment till I see the movie. So right now, I don't really know what aspects from the comics he's putting into the movie, other than he's gonna be very inspired by Frank Miller and some other stuff, which is cool, because I'm a huge Frank Miller fan. Dark Knight Returns, my favorite story of all time. Thank you, Frank Miller. Rule number four, you can't kill off villains. Rule number five, you can't kill off villains! The most disappointing part about Christopher Nolan's The Dark Knight is Two-Face. He becomes Two-Face and 10 minutes later he's dead. Sorry, I guess we'll have to wait another 20 years before they make some awesome Two-Face stories from the comics to screen. You know, Stan Lee once said in a documentary that he really was upset with comic book movies how they keep killing off villains when the point in comics is that they always come back. In Batman, the Joker never dies. He's always taken to Arkham where a month later he escapes. Or he runs away and comes back to Gotham a year later. Either way, you're not getting rid of the Joker. He can cut off his own face and he'll still come back. Rich Alvarez, actually the Dollmaker is the one that cut off the Joker's face? Eh, you know what I mean. And there you go, my personal five rules when doing comic book adaptations. That's just my opinion though. Now let's talk about that black and blue or white and gold dress. Is it blue and black or is it white and gold? The answer is very simple. It actually is a black and blue dress. It just has a yellow light on it. So your eyes, when they're trying to focus, sometimes they see it as white and gold because your eyes are trying to auto-correct. Your eyes are a machine and they're trying to see what they think you want to see. If you took a white and gold dress and put a blue light on it, then you might actually see a black and blue dress. Well, that's all the time we have on the Rich Vlog today. In honor of the late Leonard Nimoy, live long and prosper, fellas. Bye!
Mario versus Donkey Kong! Begin!
You can't step, bro, see how I get flows. Mario, I'm the real mascot of Nintendo. Just face it, your fans can step in, your crap that-